Melody Salesforce Flowsome.
Hello Flowsome people, welcome to the Salesforce Flowsome channel. In this video, we will explain what availability outside the flow means, mainly what input and output variables are. By default, when you are running a flow, you can think of this flow interview as a closed system. I will call it a scope. The flow doesn't take in any values from the outside or pass on the values to the outside. This is designed to protect your org. If you want to have a value, you will have to hard code it. If you want to get a record, you will have to use the SOQL query with literal conditions. However, hard coding in general is not a good practice because your flow will become static. To make the flow dynamic, you want to take in the values from the outside and run the flow based on different records. To do so, you will need to mark this variable as available for input to fetch the current record. Similarly, if you need to pass on this value even after the flow is finished, you have to create an available for output variable. This way, you can continue using variable outside the flow. To sum up, the use of input and output variables depends on if you want to interact with the data outside of the scope. But how do we define the scope? There is some complex programming knowledge behind this, but the easiest way to remember is one flow will create one scope. So let's check with an example. In this master flow with subflow, the master flow will create scope number one. But since the subflow is also a flow, it will create its own scope number two. When being inside the subflow, everything outside of the subflow will become out of the scope. So that's practice using the same example. First, we start with the main flow. We usually want to fetch the current record, which is outside of the scope. So you will need to create an input variable to let the system pass in the value. This is the most common use case for the input variable. Then, if we want to pass in a variable from the master flow to the subflow, since this variable is in the same scope for the master flow, you don't have to mark this variable as available for output. But then when we enter the scope of the subflow, since the value from the master flow is outside, we will need to mark this variable in subflow as available for input. Similarly, if we want to pass another variable from this subflow to the master flow, since we are passing it to the outside, we will need to mark it as available for output. But then when we return to the master scope, the variable in the master flow that stored this value doesn't need to be marked as available for input. To be honest, I got really confused when I first learned about input and output. So a very good learning tip is, when you are unsure, just don't check anything. You will start hitting errors from time to time, but that will be the perfect timing for you to learn about input and output intuitively. That's it for input and output variable. If you enjoyed this video, like, subscribe, and turn on notification. Salesforce Flowsome, thank you for watching.